only 2 eggs today? Polydus must have taken the day off. 7 8 9 2 5 9 0 3 6 0 9 3 3 0 5 3 0 5 4 8 8 2 0 4 6 6 5 2.
The Manhattan incident triggered a serious public backlash. Now the U.S. has to think twice before intervening militarily in other countries' affairs. This has fueled a push towards military privatization, with PMCs at the heart of that movement.
PMCs? Private military companies?
That's right. PMCs have no basis in nations or ideologies. They are private enterprises, driven by profit. In addition to dispatching mercenaries to war zones, they secure weapons and train local soldiers. They're contractors for war itself, and business is good. Their clientele includes developed nations like the U.S., rebel factions looking to seize power by force, smaller countries lacking armies of their own, even terrorist groups. They're in the Americas, Asia, the South Pacific, Europe, Africa, the Middle East. The rise of the PMC has spawned a war by proxy, and it's spreading across the globe.
Sonny, we'll eat them later, okay?
Every age has its mercenary. These PMCs are nothing new. We've been dealing with them since before the turn of the century.
No, Snake. They're nothing like the mercenaries of the past.
Ready.
Sorry, I'm a little busy right now.
The Pentagon's new battlefield control system has produced a decisive difference between hired guns and the PMCs of today. The system was developed by Arms Tech Security.
Arms Tech? You mean AT Corp?
Yeah. In recent years, AT Corp has shifted focus from weapons development to security tools. And since the establishment of AT Security, business has been booming. The system makes it possible to integrate not only micro-level information on individual soldiers and units, but also macro-level information about field conditions and order of battle.
So they've finally achieved total real-time battlefield control.
That's right. And as a result, the global presence of PMCs has grown explosively. Truth is, the rise of system-controlled PMCs has led to a dramatic decline in civilian casualties and human rights violations on the battlefield.
A cleaner, safer battlefield. Makes for nice propaganda.
There's more. State governments and rebel groups can't match the maintenance price of standing forces. PMCs, by comparison, are reliable, easy to use. It wasn't long before everybody had them on the payroll. And, as a result, regular armies began to decline worldwide. It's hard to believe, I know, but PMCs are beginning to overtake conventional armies in terms of scale. Nowadays, it's the PMCs who serve as standard battalions. They already make up 60% of all combatant forces in zones of conflict.
60%?
The fact is, the world now depends largely on PMCs for waging its wars.
I thought it was the UN that authorized the PMCs in the first place.
The US abstained from voting on that resolution. In effect, Washington was endorsing PMCs without ever revealing its true intentions. Until they got wind of the uprising, that is.
The US has exported too much military power. And now, she's paying the price.
That's exactly it. America has now turned war into a form of economic activity. Analysts are calling it the war economy, in that it's picking up the slack for the downward-sloping oil market. But I, for one, don't intend to simply stand by and watch it happen. For the PMCs, market expansion entails fanning the flames of war. It means more refugees.
War orphans. Child soldiers.
Yes. Even as PMC soldiers get more specialized, they're also getting younger.
Mercenaries spun off from state armies. Unmanned weapons. Child soldiers. Proxy battles in a new Cold War.
There are hundreds of PMCs in business worldwide, and their numbers are growing. Currently, five of them are big enough to be labeled global powers. Two in the US, and one each in the UK, France, and Russia. Reconnaissance has revealed that those five PMCs are run by a dummy corporation that acts as a single mother company. This mother company embodies the five largest PMCs. Her name is Outer Heaven.
Outer Heaven? You mean?
That's right. It's Liquid.
Liquid?
He's taken command of this immense army and is now preparing to unleash an insurrection.
I watched him die.
His will lives on, in the body of the man once known as Ocelot. He aims to fan the flames of war even higher, to create the perfect world once envisioned by Big Boss.
The one world in which soldiers will always have a place.
He must be stopped before it's too late. Do you understand, Snake? Any means necessary. Just stop Liquid's insurrection. Even if it means
killing him. You want Liquid dead. Isn't that right, Colonel?
I'm sorry. I know. This isn't justice. It's a covert assignment. A hired hit. A wet works op targeting the head of a major multinational corporation.
Why me?
Because of the military might of the PMC and the effect they have on the economy. War is to the 21st century what oil was to the 20th. The pillar that supports the global economy. You'll recall a rather alarming report issued by that American think tank during the Cold War. One that described a new model for perpetual war. What we're facing now is a whole new ballgame.
Iron Mountain's Delphi technique.
That was fiction. It existed only on paper. Reality is far more serious. The global community is concerned, but they're all too afraid of the war economy collapsing to do anything about it. The UN, too.
Sounds pretty self-serving to me.
Snake. This mission isn't an order from Washington. Not like the old days. And it's not something the UN can officially sanction, either. But we can't just look the other way while Liquid plots this insurrection. If we fail to act, he'll become the greatest threat the world has ever faced. Snake. You're the only man I can trust.
Let's hear it.
Our intelligence on Liquid's uprising originally comes via reports from U.S. Special Forces, who were mobilized after we at the UN reported our findings. They're tracking Liquid's movements. About 18 hours ago, he was spotted in the Middle East.
There's a rebel army in the Middle East, made up of ethnic minorities, waging civil war against the regime in power.
The core of that regime's army is provided by one of the PMCs under Liquid's control.
What about the rebels?
The local militias have hired small numbers of operators as trainers and field commanders. And of course, they've got help from the local PMCs.
Right. A proxy war between hired guns.
PMC versus PMC. A quagmire of war. All too typical victims of the new world economy. Snake, you'll be sneaking into the conflict zone via transport truck, disguised as one of the Rebel Army's hired operators. Your first objective is to make contact with our informants, Rat Patrol Team 01. They'll be expecting you.
Rat Patrol, huh? They sound sneaky.
They're a special forces team assigned to the Army's PMC Investigation Unit, CID.
CID? Real rats of the Army?
No. I can vouch for them personally.
Friends of yours?
You could say that. Transportation to the area will be provided under cover of a UN humanitarian aid mission, with support from the US military. From there on, though, you'll get no protection, and no guarantees from anyone. And you must not leave behind any evidence of your involvement in the area, let alone that of the UN. If word of this ever leaked out, it would spark a global firestorm. Snake. Will you do this for me? Will you terminate Liquid?
I'm not like the PMCs. I don't need your money.
Thank you.
But if you're going to spark something, spark this. Fine. I'll start my own fire.
Snake, hurry and get to the rendezvous point with our informants. First, you'll have to get to the other side of that collapsed building. The only way across is straight through. careful, Snake. The walls could come down any second.
It's the enemy.
Yeah, I can see him!
Perfect.
We've been spotted!
Damn it!
Return fire!
Who's there?
Go, go away! I'm not done yet!
Okay, Snake. Hurry to the rendezvous point. Your radar is marked with which way to go. Striker! The PMCs have sent reinforcements. Now they're defensive line is a lot thicker. It's gonna be tougher to break through. That striker will be shooting at you, too. Stay on your toes. It might be best to avoid that area altogether if you can.
Oh, it was you.
And what happened?
You mind explaining? Oh, it was you.
What are you doing here?
Help me out, okay?
Snake, watch out. That area is covered by PMC snipers. Boy, this is gonna be tough. If only you could find a route that takes you behind them, avoids them altogether. Thank you.
Drop your weapon! Drop your weapon!
All right. Here.
Easy now. Don't move.
You haven't even taken the safety off, rookie.
Careful. I'm no rookie. I'm a 10-year vet.
How the hell did you ever survive 10 years?
Don't move! CQC. Real big boss, huh? Lower your weapon! Slowly now. I wouldn't try anything funny if I were you.
Fox.
Snake? Snake.
Meryl.
Is that you? What happened to your face?
Accelerated aging. They don't know the cause.
Oh my God.
Meryl, you're my informant in the U.S. military.
And you must be the inspector sent by the UN. Akiba!
Commander!
Sorry.
This is Rat Patrol Team 01. We're with the CID, one of the bodies investigating PMC activity.
First hounds, now rats. Here, you can have this back. What is your problem? You okay? Stomach pains? Diarrhea?
It's been 4 days since Liquid arrived in the area. And since then, this woman's been with him. She doesn't look like a combatant, probably some kind of advisor, maybe a scientist.
You're the commander of this O-1 unit.
Why? Something wrong with that? Here, I'll introduce you to the team. That's Ed, our radio man and sniper. The sleeping giant is Jonathan. Don't stand behind him. He hates it when people go around his back. Finally. Johnny. Everybody just calls him Akiba.
Commander, I've finished installing the sensors.
Okay, Akiba. Anyway.
You're all grown up.
Maybe it's because someone taught me well. A certain legendary hero who suddenly disappeared. You quit the unit. Me? I never gave up on you. Or on Foxhound. Back then, I just wanted you to accept me. I wanted you to turn around and see who I was. But I've put the past behind. I'm done playing little love games. So, what are you here for?
Threat assessment. The PMCs.
Really? Because I heard a rumor there's an assassin out there targeting their leader.
Well, that's some rumor. I'm only here because the UN wants me to assess the impact and effects of PMCs on their refugee protection efforts.
That's all?
More than enough for a retired vet like me.
I know he's plotting an insurrection. But as long as AT Security's system is in place, there's no way he'll succeed.
How can you be so sure?
They've implemented a system that monitors in real time every single soldier engaged in combat action, whether he's State Army or PMC. Each individual soldier has been fully ID tagged with nanomachines injected into their bodies for that purpose. The nanomachines keep track of the soldiers and their real-time personal data 24 hours a day. They monitor each man's position, movement speed, reserve ammo, firing accuracy, wounds, rations, water intake and supply, sweat secreted, heart rate, blood pressure and sugar levels, oxygen. All the data gathered on body condition, on sensory organ data showing pain and fear, data on every internal response within the body. All of it is collected by an AI at the system's core. This data is monitored at HQ to enable command to make quicker, more precise, more rational decisions. It also enables crisis management for each individual soldier. It's being used by the US military, by state armies in allied countries, by PMCs. Even police agencies are starting to adopt it. Unless they agree to implement the system, PMCs aren't permitted to send troops anywhere.
You've got these system nanomachines and you too.
Of course. Our unit plays by the rules, same as everybody else. It was creepy at first, knowing you're being watched 24/7, but I've gotten used to it. It gives us a lot of advantages in the field too. We get a clearer picture of what's going on around us, so there's less confusion during missions. And our nanomachines communicate with each other, making teamwork a lot smoother. And that's not all the system does for us. It's also a security guarantee against the PMCs.
Security guarantee?
That's right. The PMCs are combat groups without states or ideologies. They're not fighting out of nationalism or for a cause. They don't care why the war is being fought. They're just bodies fighting on someone else's behalf. They're mercenaries, a commodity. So it's easy to imagine them betraying their clients by joining the enemy or refusing to fight. Or committing humanitarian atrocities. To keep these things in check, they ensured that no one can use firearms or military vehicles without the proper system ID. It's true for every piece of equipment out there. So even if the PMCs tried to mount a terrorist attack or coup d'etat, their weapons and equipment would automatically be locked out. They wouldn't be able to move, attack, or engage in combat of any kind. And there's more. All the data on their position, personnel, and combat strength is leaked to us by the nanomachines. Even if they manage to circumvent the system by getting the nanomachines out of each soldier's body, they'd be losing their IDs in the process, so they couldn't use their weapons.
And the Patriots are behind this.
Lalilulelo, what are you talking about?
Never mind. So this system is foolproof, huh?
Completely. They call it SOP.
Sons of the Patriots.
The AI that controls it is a tightly guarded secret, both at Arms Tech Security, where it was developed, and at the Pentagon. There's no way a third party could get control of it.
I just met a guy who said he can launder ID guns. The system does have holes.
There can't be more than a few hundred of those gun launderers. It's just a grassroots movement. It's not like they can affect the entire PMC war machine. Anyway, Liquid would have had to register as a PMC in the system to assemble an army that massive. His PMCs might even exceed the U.S. military in terms of numbers, but as long as they're registered, their soldiers' activities are constantly being monitored. So long as the U.S. responds immediately when Liquid makes his move, we can take them down by force.
By force, huh?
When RSOC heard about Liquid's plans, they sent us to sniff around the PMCs. Even with this SOP keeping an eye on things, there are always trouble spots to deal with in the field. Disorderly conduct, disobeying orders, contract violations. We act as backup for the system by monitoring the soldiers. PMC inspections are always carried out on the battlefield. That's why we're authorized to carry and use weapons. We've lost 5 inspection teams in the past few months alone. They were all undercover, inside Liquid's PMCs.
Then, if you got caught...
we'd be exterminated like rats. But we're smarter than that. We've been mingling with the PMCs, and after 3 months of searching God knows how many battlefields, we finally tracked him down. When we reported that we'd found Liquid, our superiors ordered us to provide the UN investigators with intel. But I didn't know it'd be you.
Didn't the Colonel tell you he was sending me?
Colonel? Don't tell me it's Campbell!
Yeah.
He put you up to this?
You didn't know.
You've gotta be kidding! You expect me to work with my uncle?
Meryl.
This is bullshit. He's not my father. Little violation of the need-to-know rule.
Then, why are you still calling him Uncle?
You're still calling him Colonel.
He's your father.
As far as I'm concerned, we're still uncle and niece. I will never forgive that womanizing piece of shit.
Meryl!
He, remarried.
Really?
His new wife's about my age. I hear she's even got a kid. It's as if he's given up on making up with his own daughter. Men. Selfish, egotistical pigs.
Commander.
What is it?
There's 20 of them, and they're not from that PMC praying mantis either. It's the Frog.
His private troops.
Oh, crap. This is not good.
Were you being followed?
No.
Akiba!
They might have seen the reflection off my scope lens.
Wait. Hang on. You guys think it was my fault? Oh. No. Oh, it wasn't my fault. I swear. It wasn't my fault. Oh, man. Oh, look.
Dumbass. We're moving out.
Meryl, where's Liquid?
At a camp up ahead. I'll fill you in later, if we're still alive. Follow me. Contact. These guys are with Liquid's private army. Shoot first, think later. We'll use the stairs and get out through the back door on the first floor. We'll change the route as necessary. I'm on point. Stay close. Got it?
Got it.
Akiba, breathe deep.
Got it.
We've got a real live legendary hero with us. Try not to choke. Move!
Get him.
contact!
Snake, Akiba's been knocked out.
Thank you.
The nanomachine network inside each unit member's body lets us share each other's senses. They can see what I see. And it helps control pain.
Is that part of the system, too?
With SOP, my team can literally operate as one. Well, except for a certain someone who's not much of a team player. So, what do you think? Is your age of heroes finally over?
I'm no hero. Never was. Never will be.
You haven't changed at all, Snake. But your body. Are you gonna be all right?
This getup doubles as a muscle suit. I can still get around.
Liquid's camp is up ahead. I'll mark it on your map.
Thanks.
Akiba! One man's blunder can compromise the whole team.
I'm sorry, Commander.
Be careful, Snake.
know where Liquid is?
Yeah, I'm confirming the location. It's to the north of where you are. Meryl's really changed, hasn't she, Snake? She's a lot more self-assured.
I wonder how much of that has to do with the system. The senses you used to develop through extended training and experience can now be obtained without even working for them. Seems once you're under the system's control, you don't even need experience at all. It even beats that VR training that was all the rage a few years back.
Yeah. The growing need for PMCs has led to the creation of a more reliable, cost-effective supply of elite soldiers. It's also made the child soldier phenomenon more problematic than ever.
Can the nanomachines do anything to counteract post-traumatic stress disorder?
Good question. They might provide a degree of psychological stability.
You'd think so? That geek kid, Akiba, he was really starting to lose it.
And technologically, the system should be able to optimize each soldier's personality traits.
And that big guy, he didn't seem to be feeling any pain at all.
Augmenting the soldier's existing experience and psychological fortitude.
But a soldier's gotta have more than that.
The times have changed, Snake. Just like Meryl. Snake, hurry to the PMC camp. Based on what Meryl told us, Liquid should be there.
Okay, time to head for the surface.